especially primary school children, all of them. And don't forget that this would also help with the whole obesity programme. I personally worked on some social research over in Wirral, and we found out that children who were having the much improved school dinners that became available about 9 to 10 years ago were actually less obese. This is a significant factor. I don't want to take up people's time too much, but is anybody aware, I know some people on the council are, of the study that was done about the same time, 9 or 10 years ago in Durham. But are people aware that they increased their academic performance by 38% when they were offering all primary school children a free school dinner? So I think this is the way forward. More free school meals, please. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, my Lord Mayor. In today's society, by speaking to professionals, school teachers, and people who work in housing associations, I've been made aware that, you know, our children are going hungry every single day during breakfast, and now the concerns are teachers are worried that children are going to go hungry through the summer, the families can't afford to feed them. We are fully in favour of this motion. To reduce the amount that a parent can earn to £7,400 is very, very cruel on the hard-working poor families. And also, you know, if you want to have a creative, healthy society in the future, we have to feed our children. So we are fully in favour of this motion, and I thank you. I thank the council for bringing it to council this evening.
Thank you.
Thank you, my Lord Mayor. I mean, I think we have to be absolutely clear what this is. This is an attack on the working poor. This is everyone who's affected. If they earn minimum wage, will earn no more than 78 to 18 hours a week. They're the people who are going to be affected by this kind of measure. And that's significant and important in this city because 25% of people who are working in the city earn minimum wage. We're going to have a motion and debate next around hospitality wages in terms of conditions, and the impact of that is relevant as well to this. 2 years ago, I was invited by the Children's Commissioner for a commission that she was doing called Growing Up North, and it was about looking at what they can do as a Children's Commission, as a commission, to improve the lives of children up north. And I had to point out that children up north aren't actually wearing clogs. It's the same issue in Liverpool as it is anywhere else in the country. It's an issue of poverty. It's just there might be more of it here than it is in other places, but it's an issue that affects people right across the country. Esther McVeigh was one of the members of that commission. She wasn't in Parliament then because she'd been voted out from the Wirral, let us remember, quite likely for what she did when she was in government in coalition with the Liberal Democrats when they started cutting some of these benefits back in 2010. So I said to her, because they were talking about education, education performance, how can you expect children to perform better in school if they're coming into school hungry? Because we're all seeing, particularly those of us who are representing the poorer wards in the city, that there's a huge growth in the numbers of children that are attending breakfast clubs. Has grown incredibly. The youth clubs that are feeding children in summer holidays now is growing probably virtually across the city. My colleague, Councillor Parsons, is telling me that 900 children were fed from one children's centre last summer. So this is the impact that this kind of measure is having on our children. And when I said to the Children's Commissioner, if you wanted to do something about the impact on children and poverty and food, then you need to look at the terms and conditions of employment of their parents. And she told me, nah, that's too difficult to do. It wasn't mentioned in the report that she produced, but it's not too difficult to do. And when we debate the motion next, we can see that it isn't, because we have to pay people decent pay in terms and conditions, and it's not too difficult to overturn this particular nasty anti-child measure, because all we have to do is vote to the Labour government, because one of the first things we'll do is abolish this terrible anti-child legislation.
Thank you,
charging £1 a day. They couldn't even afford to pay £1 a day. They're getting into even more debt because they had to do it on tip until they got the allowances or the legal wages in order to pay it back. We've just also done a Food for Teens initiative in our ward. We've paid on our hardship fund to work with young people from the ages of 12 to 17. If you can't feed a child or a child is going hungry, not only is that about food poverty, that's also about leaving them open to an environment where they're going to be placed in a position where they're going to be forced down the road of criminal activity or such as the like, in order to provide not only for themselves, but also to provide for their families. We've got children under immense stress and pressure, not because they're going hungry, but because they know their parents are also going hungry and their siblings are going hungry. We've got to change this, and we can't change this under this government. It's absolutely heart-wrenching to see what's going on, not just in this city, but nationally.
Lord Mayor, you know I'm always brief. Thank you. I cannot top the excellent maiden speeches by Councillor Doyle and Councillor Hayden. But what I can say is we have evidence in this city about the great work that the Mayor, Councillor Small, Councillor Corbett, Councillor Murray and Councillor Lana Orr has led on over the last few years in education. And that relates to one case study. Find out about the difference free school meals has done for Whitefield Primary in Everton. They have gone from a school that required improvement to officially being one of the top 10 schools in the entire United Kingdom because of the work that our schools and our inspirational head teachers and our leadership and our staff have provided. By introducing free school meals, that school has improved its attendance levels by 8%. It is now over 98%, one of the best. It has improved attainment and it's improved health. So if you want to see what can be done, go and speak to Nadine Carroll and discover what an amazing school that is. But I don't want to see just free school meals. I want to see free meals every single day for every child in this city, because that's what we should be doing. And the sooner that Jeremy Corbyn is our Prime Minister, the better. Thank you.
Mayor Anderson.
Well, Jane and myself heard the story, I think it was 2 years ago when we set up the commission and we did all the things with the charities, and it was about the little boy taking his sister in some holidays and he couldn't get into school and he was taking his sister for something to eat because she was crying and hungry, and they went to the school gates and across the school was on school day and he didn't know that, and it was heartbreaking. And then we heard the story of somebody being sanctioned who was eating up beans in a kettle to feed. So, you know, I've always argued in, you know, that when people talk about poverty and we get statistics, but the reality is it's much, much worse than we even think, because no one knows what goes on in terms of behind the doors here. And the fact of the matter is, we have to be the eyes and ears, and so when Annette talked about a particular case, we have to make sure that we are, if you like, using our antenna and picking up information from people in different communities, because we will provide support if we're informed about that. But you know, we've got to not only do things like raise the inequality and the travesty of a system that allows this to happen, and that's absolutely right. I mean, Councillor Hayden talked about campaigning and using our teachers, our schools, our social workers, our everybody to join together to articulate that point. But we've also got a lot of the things that we do, and that includes working with the schools to see if we can provide additional support to them, and they help us, because some of them are sitting on reserves, about how we can provide support and fund them to help with meals. We've got to do other things as well, like challenge the schools. Why is it that, you know, they want blue blazers, red blazers, wrong with establishing a school emblem at one time rather than parents forced? Because part of the problem as well, it's about poor attendance, it's about bullying, it's about self-esteem of kids, is that often they won't attend school because they haven't got the top pair of trainers, or even shoes, proper black shoes or whatever, and they don't want to go to school, and all of those things have to be addressed, so we can do that with schools, but we can actually also challenge the schools to work with us to do things better. And that's where we come in terms of leadership and demanding that our schools do that. We'll continue to provide as much support as we can with the limited resources we've got, but poverty and children are always important.
Councillor Doyle, Councillor Hayden, what a wonderful speech. Just you've opened the floor. But I don't wish to. With your permission, I'm going to go straight for the vote. Is that okay? Thank you. All in favour? Three. Unanimous. Thank you. Item 40.